All right, good evening, and welcome back to the U18, Under-18 Atlantic Soccer Showcase. We are live at Raymond Field on the campus of Acadia University in Wolfville, Nova Scotia. And midfield, you see the two combatants in this game lined up, shaking hands. The Nova Scotia U18 girls team wearing the all-blue with white numbers, taking on Valley United, wearing the red with white numbers. And Valley United, part of the Nova Scotia entrance here in terms of soccer Nova Scotia, because of one team unfortunately not being able to make it into the tournament to keep things kind of even up and to keep the schedule the way it was. Soccer Nova Scotia was asked to provide some teams to fill out the bracket, so to speak. So Valley United gets that position here today. And they're being coached by Amit Batra, the coach of the women's team from right here at Acadia University. And a couple of his players actually playing on the Nova Scotia under 18 girls side. And the majority of the players on his Valley United team also committed to Acadia University. So it's almost like Amit is either getting to watch or coach his very own Acadia University women's soccer team. So that's kind of a neat little sideline. And for Coach Kate McDonald, who is an alumni of Dalhousie University, she's coaching a very experienced and talented group of girls on the under 18 side. Most of the girls on this Nova Scotia U18 team have already committed to attend various colleges and universities in the United States and Canada next year. We'll get to more of that throughout the broadcast, but places like Maine, Alabama, and Memphis, just to name a couple of the American locations that some of these Nova Scotia U18 girls will be attending next year. So a nice matchup taking place here today. Starting in goal for the Nova Scotia under-18 side will be number one, Samantha Sardi. She's committed to St. Mary's University for next year. And then Alexa McClatchy-Gadette will take care of goaltending in the second half for Nova Scotia. For Valley United, it'll be Emma Connell, going the entire way. She of the number zero, or as an old Celtics fan like myself, Robert Parrish's number. Whenever I think of the uniform number zero, I always think of Robert Parrish. Although as she heads back to goal, she's got a one on the back of her jersey, although the player's listings that I was given had her listed as zero. But that's okay. It's her prerogative. She can wear a one. I still like my Robert Parrish story, though. It's still true. So Valley United wearing the red, going left to right, and Nova Scotia U18 girls wearing the blue, right to left. We are underway. Nice to have you with us. 40-minute halves here. So quickly, the ball goes out of bounds. And I asked Coach Kate McDonald from the Nova Scotia side, I said, what's your formation for opening up? She said 4-3-3, which is a pretty standard formation for strikers, midfield, and your back line of defenders. And then I asked Coach Batra, I said, Emmett, I said, hey, Coach, what's your alignment? He looked at me with a wink and a smile and said, hey, 4-1, 4-1. I said, ah, I like that. That's different. So, ball down in the Valley United end. Nova Scotia, the U18 side, keeping it up in play. This is Valley United now pushing it forward. There's Sinclair. Mackenzie Sinclair gets it back to Nicole Wombolt. Quick ball up toward midfield. And that'll go out of bounds. It'll be a throw in for Team Nova Scotia. Early stages here of this first half. Third game of the day from the U18 Atlantic Soccer Showcase. Scott Squires and the Bell Align TV1 crew. Glad to have you on board with us. It's been a pretty solid breeze blowing all day here today at Raymond Field. And pretty much the same situation. It's been a strong breeze coming off the water, which would be to the left of your picture. And it's been blowing pretty much straight left to right all day long. Ball stopped there by Armitage. Pushing it back there was Emily Cheverie. Nova Scotia looking to move that ball up. Cheverie gets it over toward the middle of the field. Long ball forward. And Valley will get to it first. Jumping on that loose ball was Rachel Henry. Henry takes it along the goal line, tries to feed it out in front there in a nice effort. And that cross just broken up at the last minute. But a good effort there by Rachel Henry. Nova Scotia keeps coming forward now. Pushing the pace here early on. They'll look to get it in the middle again. Henry there and tried to get the right foot on it. And just couldn't get the angle and the position in time as that ball was crossed right over into the middle where Rachel Henry was waiting for it and just couldn't get the clean shot away. But a couple of good attempts toward goal in the last few seconds here by this Nova Scotia U18 side. Back to get it was Emma O'Connell. Taking her time with this goal kick. And it's moved forward. And again, scrambly play. Ball whistled down. It'll stay with Valley. Free kick for them. On their side of center, just outside the 40-yard mark. Long ball pushed ahead. Goes over everybody in red. Man, it's picked up by Nova Scotia. Fighting for it there is Hannah Bruce. Hannah Bruce gets it up on that sideline and trying to keep it in, but it does roll out as Emily Cheverie was trying to get a hold of it. And that ball goes off the leg of Hannah Bruce and out of play. It'll be thrown in now by Jillian Tetlow. Nova Scotia comes down with it, chipped over by Fielding. Here we go, right along that sideline again. Ball pushed up for Cheverie. Cheverie looking for some help down that line. She's got Henry trying to make a run, went the other way with it. And it's cleared out towards center. Lifting that ball forward now is Armitage. Blocked down by Valley, and they'll gain control. And they'll move it right back the other way. Ball comes down onto the foot of Emily Cheverie once again. Turn back the other way now, and Mackenzie Sinclair. Little chip forward. That went off the foot of Megan Earl. Earl trying to get to that ball first. Earl, good challenge there coming from Hannah Bruce. And Bruce gets there just in time to force that ball out, but it will be a corner for Valley United. Just over 5 minutes gone off the clock here in this first half. 40-minute halves again in this Atlantic Soccer Showcase. Games, of course, today, tomorrow, Saturday, and Sunday, and we'll have all the action for you right here on Bell Alliant TV1. Corner coming in now from Stevens. Right into the middle there. A couple players tried to get ahead on. There's another header towards goal. Bodies flying, ball down. Shot toward goal, but it goes high and up over top, but some good action off of that corner kick from Valley United. And that's the best opportunity they've had on the offensive side of things. Again, quite a few of the players on this Valley United team are also players for Acadia University. So Coach Amit Batra, very familiar with this side. Knocking it down there was Stevens. And spinning around was Mackenzie Sinclair. Stevens now tries to run onto it. And she got tied up momentarily by Armitage. And again, the ball goes out. It's a brisk evening now here in Wolfville, Nova Scotia, just past 6:41 Atlantic time. You can send us a message on Twitter, comment on the teams, the game, tell us who you're cheering for. If you know somebody on one of the teams, send out your tweet, use the hashtag TV1. Be a goal kick now for Nova Scotia. Samantha Sardi sets it down, makes sure that everybody is in position, at least from her point of view. Ball goes right up toward midfield. Stopped there by Rachel Henry. Henry looking to make a nice run there, but gets turned back quickly. And the ball once again out of play. Time continues to tick off the clock here. Just into our eighth minute of play. Ball again, just on the Valley United side of the field. Comes back to midfield now. Nova Scotia regroups just a little. Ball over on this near side for Hannah Bruce. Bruce goes up along for Cheverie. Cheverie being challenged there by Tetlow. Tetlow comes away with it. Good defensive play. Trying to catch up to it now is Stevens for Valley United. And again, the ball goes out of play. Ball thrown in by Tetlow. Comes down to Nova Scotia. Sinclair. Put her back to the defender there for a moment. But play is whistled down and Valley United now will have a free kick. Katie Ross gets ready to take this free kick from just about the 43 and a half yard line. Lifts that ball in. The wind kind of takes it a bit. And I think that ball stayed aloft a little longer than perhaps Katie thought that it might, but a good job by the goaltender Sardi to judge that wind and to pluck it out of the air once it came down. There's a good wind blowing here, as mentioned, and maybe I'll tweet out a picture of my roster sheets that I've got written out here. There was no tape available at our broadcast site, and looking for some duct tape, none available, so I'm using a combination of clipboards, technical gear, and post-it notes to hold my papers down. I think I am going to have to tweet a picture of that out. That's behind the scenes on Air Life, my friends. Valley United, ball right up through the middle, kind of went through everybody. Neat little pass. Megan Earl gets onto it. Earl now sliding, trying to chip it forward, and the ball will go out of play. Just a little over 10 minutes gone by here in this first half. Still no score. Valley United stepping in here to fill out the bracket of this showcase. Good of them to do that. Getting a little extra soccer work in here and providing some good competition for a very experienced Nova Scotia under 18 side. Goal kick again, coming from Nova Scotia. Moving in with it. A harmless little roller there from Stevens. handled easily by Sardi. And Nova Scotia now will turn it right back. They'll walk it up that line once again, trying to move it forward. Good job there as Sinclair picked it off. Mackenzie Sinclair has Earl hanging around that center part. Tries to get it over to her. Diving save made by Sardi as the cross came in. Another chance, and Sardi grabs it and holds on. So a nice effort there and a good set play. But Sardi in goal for Nova Scotia thwarts the Valley United effort and keeps it scoreless. But just a nice effort there. And Valley United almost counted on the scoreboard. Trying to make a run again now is Jackie Stevens. Stevens gets a couple of defenders right on her back. Somehow weaves her way through, gets taken down. Very strong tackle there. And Nova Scotia will carry on. So to use the hockey vernacular in this particular case, it would appear that head referee is letting these two sides play here. There's been a couple of stiff tackles, no whistles, and the two sides carry right on. Ball up towards center. Chipped in by Earl, but Nova Scotia calmly step it down, and it's Bruce who gets it over into midfield. Sweeping it over there was Megan Fielding. Nova Scotia will once again bring it over that center line now into the Valley United end. The back line of Valley United calmly blocks it down. And Nova Scotia tried to make a run in there, and the ball again goes out of bounds, so it'll be a throw-in for Valley United. And taking the throw-in will be Jillian Tetlow. Goes to Mount Allison University, but also plays for Valley, from the Valley. Cutting over towards the middle now is Cheverie. And Valley United scrambling to clear that ball, and it goes out of play across the track and up into the stands. Still no score here, 0-0. The field lights at Raymond Field have been turned on as the sun begins to set just a little, and some cloud cover has sailed its way over Wolfville here. Valley United making a run now down that far side, trying to get it over in toward the middle, as darting in there was Megan Earl, but they couldn't get the ball to her, and it was broken up at the last minute. A couple of players on the Nova Scotia U18 side would normally be playing for Emmett Batra at Acadia University, and that would be number 15, Serena Dolan, and also Kennedy Curry. Kennedy Curry wearing number 8 for Nova Scotia, and Serena Dolan wearing Serena Dolan wearing number 7. So Dolan and Curry would normally play for Emmett Batra, but hanging out and playing some football for the Nova Scotia U18 side. Just under 24 and a half minutes left here in this first half. No score, Nova Scotia U18 girls and Valley United. Ball over on this near side. Coming forward with it now is Shannon Armitage. She tried to get it up for Dolan, that didn't connect. Nice play by Henry to push it over toward the middle. Here is Dolan now. Little chip pass there as she had a teammate darting up toward the front, couldn't get it to her. Valley breaks up, it comes down on the foot of Dolan again, who tries to get it through that wall of red. Can't do so. Ball comes out to about the 35-yard mark. And now Valley United breaking away, trying to get that lead ball up for Ferguson, broken up at the last minute. for Earl, and Megan Earl pushes it up the line, and it will go out of bounds. Join myself and Cyril Lunny as we chat each Monday at 8:40 a.m. on the Sideline Scoop. Get up to date on Bell Aline TV One's local sports coverage with myself and Cyril. That's the Sideline Scoop, Mondays at 8:40 a.m. on CTV Morning Live Atlantic. Always a lot of fun sitting down and chatting with Cyril on CTV Morning Live Atlantic, Monday mornings at 8:40 Atlantic time. It's a great crew there at CTV, a lot of fun. We always enjoy showing highlights of the events that we've covered and talking about events we've got coming up on Bell Aline TV One. Remember, you can get information on our coverage, both webcast-wise, live-wise, and our on-demand content at bellaliant.ca/TV1. That ball bounced in front of the goal, past everybody, and then ends up going out in behind the goal. Nova Scotia will move that ball up now. There's been a couple of close chances at both ends, but we still remain scoreless. Turning with that ball is Rachel Henry. She's been pretty dangerous here for Nova Scotia in this first half. Valley United now just going back and forth between their back line, just trying to get organized. As we push our way towards the halfway mark of this half. That's blocked down there. Cheverie got a foot on it. And now it's back to Hannah Bruce. Bruce moves it gingerly forward, comes back to her. Bruce being watched there by Smith Nose, by Noseworthy Smith, excuse me. Trying to make a nice run around there with Cheverie. Still gets a foot on it. Gets it back to Dolan and finally does go out of bounds. So some pretty good footwork in tight quarters there by number four, Emily Cheverie. Be attending Ottawa University. Ottawa U for Miss Cheverie next year. I guess not even next year, really, just in a few months. Hard to believe that it's May and it's only a few months and the university year will be upon us once again. Ball in toward the middle and trying to get some part of the body on it there was Rachel Henry. Couldn't connect. In digging forward there was Dolan, but she had it taken away and right back the other way comes Earl. Megan Earl, 1v1 battle, goes right through the legs of Armitage. Nice move there. Chips it over to her mate on the side. And losing the handle on it there was Stevens. And Nova Scotia comes away with it now as Cheverie goes just past Bruce. Nova Scotia with it again now. Good battle there defensively as coming over to help out was Katie Ross. Ball moved forward. Jumping on it right away was Bruce. Hannah Bruce. Little chip forward now. Can Megan Fielding catch up to it? Fielding looks to be out of gas there, and she just gets shouldered off the ball by her opposite number 12, Jillian Tetlow. So Tetlow does a nice job of catching up to Fielding there and bodying her off the ball. We have indeed now crossed the halfway point of this first half into the 21st minute here. Still no score between Valley United in red and the Nova Scotia U18 girls in blue. Both teams have had opportunity, but neither side able to cash in, at least not yet. Play still in around that midfield area over on the far side. Nova Scotia looking to move it up a little. Cheverie gets it up. And it goes just a little bit too far, so it'll be a goal kick for Valley United and Emma Connell. Nova Scotia intercepts that ball again. Tried to work it into the middle there to find Rachel Henry. Nova Scotia, a few times now, have tried to set Henry up, but has yet to be able to connect. Ball all the way down into the other end. And both teams having a little bit of problem generating some offense right now. As at least on the field level, a little bit of sun peeking through that cloud cover. We had a glorious, clear, blue sky, sunny day earlier. And as the afternoon progressed into early evening, a little bit of cloud settled over the field. The field lights have come on. And the breeze has remained a constant. The only difference is it's gotten a slight bit cooler. Here's Bruce, gets it forward, and now gets it back. Pushes it over into the middle of the field where Megan Fielding will look to chase it down, and Nova Scotia sends it back into their own end. Shannon Armitage will watch it roll back to her keeper, Samantha Sardi. They get it quickly back up to Armitage. She goes cross-field with it. Nova Scotia trying to move that ball ahead. And now, not liking the setup, they decide to regroup and go back to their keeper, Sardi. Moving it forward. Buckler. Into the middle of the field. Nova Scotia with control. Up for Bruce. Bruce, a little chip ahead. Spinning with it there was Henry. Back to Buckler. Buckler, far side, broken up. Valley United will clear it right down the field, and it's onto the leg of Snowsworthy Smith. United now bringing it back. Up the sideline and not able to connect on the pass, and the ball goes out of play. ...16 minutes left to play here in this first half. One game to come after this one, and it'll be boys action. The Nova Scotia under 18 team taking on the New Brunswick under 17. Rachel O'Coyne couldn't catch up to that. And both teams now will reset as the ball gets set to be put back into play. Nova Scotia with the little throw in. Quickly on the ball there was O'Coyne. O'Coyne going back and forth between the two Nova Scotia players, trying to force the issue. Ball up ahead, chipped nicely off the head by Chivery, but it's blocked down by Valley United, and they'll come back the other way with it. Through midfield, a couple of Nova Scotia defenders turn it right back around. Henry on that right side. Henry now will make a run. They can't get it to her, and Valley will send it right back the other way. Armitage gets it forward, but then they play it right back to that back line. Looking to try and find a way to get through this red wall of Valley United defenders. Here comes Nova Scotia. Ball up now for Bruce. Bruce has it on that left side. Over into the middle. Nobody there, and the ball cleared out onto the running track once again, and the teams will have to reset, and the ball will be inbounded. And it's thrown in there by Armitage. Comes onto the foot of Chivery. Now to Dolan. And Dolan gives it off. Nova Scotia looking to work it in if they can. Armitage all the way across the field. Over on that far side of the pitch now. Nova Scotia try to work it forward. Nice defensive coverage by that back end of Valley. And it's whistled down and that free kick now for Team Nova Scotia. From about the 36-yard mark. Off the back of the head of Chivery, and you could hear it up here. She said, ow! as that kind of hit her a little bit awkwardly on the back part of her head. In with it now is Bruce. Bruce gets challenged there. Strong defensive play by Jillian Tetlow. And a substitution coming in now for Valley United. Checking into the game, number 8, who I do not have a name for. And given some of the things that have gone on with rosters and not having names and numbers and so on, I do apologize for that, but I can only go with what I'm given. So Mackenzie Sinclair sits down, and number 8 into the game for Valley. That ball kicked out of play there by O'Coin. Time continues to tick off the clock here in this first half. No score. Ball comes back to Tetlow. She went up along the line there. Now it's Bruce for Nova Scotia. That's picked off. Bruce slides over, digs a heel in, gets that ball toward midfield with Valley. Work it back up on this near side. Earl bounces it over toward the goal. No problem there as Sardi gathers it up and moves it forward. Chevrolet now moves it up again. Here comes Fielding. Fielding tried to get it over, and that was just beyond the reach of Emily Chevrolet. Throw in for Valley. O'Coin turned over again, and Armitage will take it. Armitage looks, delivers the ball up through the middle. Three red shirts there surrounding Rachel Henry. And it's Valley who come away with that ball forward now, and it's a nice one for Earl, but she couldn't run onto it, and it goes just past her. But a nice idea as Earl was in the open. They tried to feed it to her, but didn't connect. Samantha Sardi getting her cardio in. Gets a good run back to pick up that ball. Samantha will be attending St. Mary's in the fall. Nova Scotia trying to work it up along the line there, looking for Bruce. Now it comes to her. Bruce turns now. Here she comes. Bruce turns on the Jets, gets it over in toward the middle of the field. Spinning there was Henry. It was a nice ball over, but Henry couldn't control. Nova Scotia still has it, though. And finally, Valley able to get a foot on it and clear it out of bounds. 10 minutes left to play here. First half action between Valley United and the Nova Scotia U18 girls side. Valley again will clear that ball up. Nobody home, and it goes out of play once again. Play whistled down once again. And even though you see the football markings on the turf, it is comforting to know that Raymond Field is a FIFA-approved artificial turf stadium. So certainly more than adequate to host a soccer event like this. United, long ball forward. That got a little air under it, and that's onside. Trying to catch up to it was Earl. And she kind of took a bit of a knee and went down for a moment. Was a little slow getting up, but seems to be back into it there. Does 17 in red. Megan Earle. It was a good ball forward, and she almost was able to get in behind the defense for a break. But in any case, it's Nova Scotia back the other way with Megan Fielding. Over to Bruce. Bruce goes to the back line now. Waiting for it there was Armitage. Back up for Chevry. Chevry tried to lift it forward as Dolan looked to make a run. So you can see both of these teams, they have clever little ideas and they try to execute. But on the opposite end, defensively, both of these teams just as clever. So to this point, both teams having a hard time getting any kind of offensive creativity through some very good defensive play. Almost like a bit of a chess match here on the defensive end of things. But a lot of talent on both of these sides. You would expect at some point one of these offensive pushes are going to find their way to the back of the goal. This is Chevry now. Tried to move it forward for Henry. Henry got by one defender, but not the second, but gives it away to Walsh. Julia Walsh tried to move it up, but Valley, well, turned back. Calling for it on this near side is number seven, Rachel O'Coin. She had her arm up the whole way. Tried to feed that ball into the middle again. Megan Earle was making a dash toward the front of the goal, but once again, couldn't get it to her. .6:45 left to play in this first half. Of course, that's also dependent on the head referee. They do have final say in the official timing of the half. So I will say unofficially, 6:25 left. Nova Scotia making that ball forward now. It's Chevry. Being watched closely there by O'Coin. That 1v1 battle has come to pass a few times here in this one. Over on the side now for Dolan. That was broken up and back to midfield once again. This is Bruce. Just calmly dumps it off. Chipped up ahead for Dolan. She moves it toward the middle of the field. Chevry tries to go around her defender for Henry. Henry couldn't come up with it. She comes up face to face with Ross. Ross in there looking for it again for Valley. Once again back to midfield, and Nova Scotia will regroup and try to get this long ball forward. Only red jerseys there, and it's cleared up on that far side. Ball lifted high in the air. Trying to get forward again was Earle. This is Earle. She has it again on the far side. O'Coin calling for it. That's two or three times now that Rachel O'Coin has run down that right side for Valley with the arm up, calling for the pass. They haven't found her yet. Spinning with it now is Wombolt. Back line, this is Nickerson. Nickerson, quick little pass up ahead, turned right back, and it goes onto the foot of Henry. Henry steps around one defender. How much gas does Henry have? She chips it off to the far side. Henry goes down and is slow to get up. Meanwhile, her mates carry on. Nova Scotia taking it deep into the Valley end, and meanwhile, in behind the play, Rachel Henry still slow to get up. Nice bit of sportsmanship there as a Valley United player came over to check on her. And perhaps not within camera view, but behind the play, Rachel Henry stretching out that right leg just a little bit. Rachel Henry will be going to school in Jacksonville in September. So I would imagine it'll be slightly warmer in Jacksonville in September than it is right now in Wolfville in May. Ball goes to the back line now, picked up there by Armitage. Nova Scotia looks to move that ball up. Ahead and chipped by Dolan. Sky high ball comes down onto the foot of O'Coin. O'Coin stumbles just a little bit, but is still able to move that ball forward. Spinning with that ball now is Noseworthy Smith. Here comes Nova Scotia. Nice little ball chipped ahead. Some good pace now for Nova Scotia as they come into the zone. Ball through! And a nice through ball there coming from Julia Walsh. But just a little bit too far. Right idea. Just didn't get the execution she needed, but it really looked good there for a moment as Nova Scotia had pace. And it was Walsh trying to get it ahead for Henry, who was onside and in behind the defense, but just a little too much pace on that ball. And it ended up going into the arms of Emma Connell. United now. .230 left in this half. This is Henry. Chips just in behind. Over into midfield. Trying to work with it there was Fielding. Fielding hits the turf, and it's Katie Ross who comes up with the ball, and she pushes it back. Play right at that center field stripe. Henry again goes off to that right side. And she'll make a run forward herself. Henry gets that ball back, takes it in deep. Can she cross it over toward the goal? She's being hounded there, but nice work by Henry. Gets it over into the middle, and trying to get a leg on it there was Buckler. And she did actually get a foot to that ball, but it ended up going over top of the goal. But again, nice effort there by Rachel Henry. About a minute and a half unofficially left in this first half. Of course, we'll keep an eye and an ear on the head referee. Valley trying to get it forward again with O'Coin. Picked off by Nova Scotia. This is Henry in the middle, and her shot was blocked down. This is O'Coin. O'Coin goes back into the middle, and Wombolt goes back to her teammate, and Valley now will look to get that ball forward. A line of blue right across the back, block it down and send it up toward midfield. Unofficially inside the final minute now. See the referee in my view. Just took a look at his watch, so we're pretty much on the same page, are the head referee and myself. Ball over along that far line, out of bounds. And still no score here. And really not a whole lot of chances offensively. A couple of shots on goal, a few more directed toward goal, but really nothing too threatening from an offensive standpoint. I would expect that whistle to blow any time now. 2 minutes of added time. 2 minutes of added time. So we are inside referees' added time here in this first half. I've always been curious how the head official or head referee calculates how much extra time to add. I'm pretty sure it's an arbitrary number, based on the fact that in the game we had earlier, there was about the same amount of stoppages and same amount of gameplay in terms of, you know, there weren't a lot of injuries, there weren't a lot of out-of-bounds plays, and the head referee didn't have any extra time added at the end of the half. And in this particular case, the head referee decided 2 minutes was adequate. So it's always interesting how they kind of tally up that arbitrary number of extra time. Maybe they have an extra time dice that they roll. Or a die, I guess, singular. So according to my stopwatch, we would be inside the final minute of extra time here. Is there time for one more push from either team? Nova Scotia thinks so. Long ball in! And that was a long-range strike from Serena Dolan. That just went wide. She Should be inside a half minute now in this half. Goal kick out. Pushed forward off the foot of Stevens. And expect the blow on the referee's whistle any time now. O'Coyne tried to get to it, but it's Shannon Armitage first. She loses it now, gets it over into the middle for Stevens. Stevens lost the handle. And as Dolan tried to rush up the field, there is indeed the referee blowing the whistle. That takes care of the first half of action. Not a whole lot to talk about offensively. And we will step aside after one half of play. You're watching the Under 18 Atlantic Canada Soccer Showcase, sponsored by Soccer Nova Scotia and presented live and exclusively on Bell Alliant TV One. Your score after one half, Val United 0, Nova Scotia Under 18 Girls 0. We'll be back with second half action in about 10 minutes. Welcome back. Had a slight technical difficulty that we had to quickly correct on the fly. Live webcasting. Sometimes that's what you gotta do. So we are underway here in this second half from the Atlantic Soccer Showcase under 18 version. This game featuring the Nova Scotia U18 girls team wearing the all blue with white numbers, taking on Valley United in all red with white. No score as we play here in this second half. Both teams had a little bit of difficulty trying to get any kind of offense going in that first half. We'll see what adjustments that the coaches may have made during halftime. Coach Kate McDonald for the Nova Scotia side and Coach Amit Batra for Valley United. Ball forward, trying to catch up to it there. Was fielding. Got it over, nice effort. And a good job there by Emma Connell to come off her line and scoop that ball up. Out toward midfield, off the head there of Dolan. Over on that far side, Nova Scotia. They'll just go to their back line now and regroup. Armitage brings that ball upfield. Making a run down the right side now is Bruce. And it's Henry. Henry trying to get there first, but she's intercepted by Emily Nickerson. Nickerson plays for Acadia. Chantel Cadeau, number 6, is an alumni of Acadia. Several other players play for Acadia as well. Abby Cook, Kinsella Nosworthy-Smith, along with Jackie Stevens, Megan Earle, and Katie Ross. So a good number of Acadia University soccer players playing on this Valley United side. A couple of other Acadia players, as mentioned in the first half, playing for the Nova Scotia side, but also play for Coach Batra at Acadia, Serena Dolan, and Kennedy Curry. So a good workout for Acadia soccer here. Bruce sends it back. Nova Scotia will look to get it up now. Dolan. And now it's fielding. Fielding gets that ball ahead. Slow roller up forward. Trying to get it over into the middle. But it's Abby Cook who gets it up toward midfield. Comes back to Cook again. She decides to run with it now. Some good dribbling up the field. Good footwork there, but it's back to Nova Scotia. Armitage, strong game so far for Nova Scotia. Gets it to Ferguson. Nicole Ferguson for Henry to Ferguson. Goes to the back line, and Emma Connell making no mistake. Grabs that ball and hangs on. Nice work there as Acadia keeps it along the line. And this is Cook again. Abby Cook goes into the middle. Sniffing around for it there was Dolan. She couldn't come up with it. And again, Valley United goes to their back line to regroup. Far side ball forward. Nice little pass ahead. Valley now trying to move it up the field bit by bit. Into the middle, chip pass! And almost a glorious opportunity there in front as just little bit by little bit, little 3-4 foot passes by Valley slowly progressed the ball up the field, and then they saw the opportunity, tried to work it over in toward the front of the goal, and Alexa McClatchy-Gadet had to be smart in there, and it went harmlessly off to the side, but nice effort by Valley. Ferguson had it come off of her, and now down in the control of Valley, but stepping up there and taking a bit of a collision on the lower shin was Hannah Bruce, and you could kind of hear the clash up here. Lucky she has those shin guards on underneath those high-knee soccer socks. But you could hear the collision up here, and when it happened, she immediately clutched at her lower leg, but I think it was just more of a kind of an adjust the sock, adjust the shin guard kind of deal. Back underway. Everybody's doing all right. No lingering effects there on Hannah Bruce. Nova Scotia with control again. Ball rolls forward past Dolan for Nova Scotia, and Valley will go all the way back to Connell, and she'll just move it forward. And this is basically a carbon copy of what we saw in the first half. Both teams trying to find a way to break through, but the majority of the play being between the two 30-yard lines on either side. And that's kind of the way that it's been throughout. The real good offensive opportunities have been few and far between, that's for sure. Ball thrown in, and it comes into control of Nova Scotia. They move it over on this near side. They'll look to move that ball forward now. Armitage gets it up ahead. Trying to run onto it there was Mahoney. That didn't work out, and Valley will turn it back. It's up into the clouds. Finally comes down. And again, Nova Scotia has control, and that ball rolls out of bounds. Double Lion TV One is proud to be the official webcaster for the 2016 U18 Atlantic Soccer Showcase presented by Soccer Nova Scotia. Games are coming to you live from Raymond Field on the campus of Acadia University in Wolfville, Nova Scotia. Bell Alliant, there's more to love with FiberOp. Ball bouncing now down into that Nova Scotia zone. McClatchy Gaudette picks it up and she'll hang on. Into the eighth minute we play here in this second half, 48th minute overall. Again, just a reminder, it is 40-minute halves. Ball brought down, quickly moved forward by Nicole Ferguson. Trying to run onto it once again is Henry. Henry gets it back, trying to find a cutting Holly Buckler who was coming into the middle. Smart play there by Henry. Just couldn't get the right connection with Buckler. But not a bad idea at all by number 10 in blue, Rachel Henry. Play into the midfield area. This is Serena Dolan. Dolan will be going to school in Memphis in September. That's right. Going to Graceland, Memphis, Tennessee. The good old Paul Simon song. So again, just one of the schools that are at interesting locations in terms of North American locales that a lot of these Nova Scotia girls will be going to next year. So to go down the list, Serena Dolan will be going to University in Memphis. Hannah Bruce will be going to Utah Valley. Mentioned Rachel Henry will be going to Jacksonville. Megan Fielding will be attending school in Alabama. Shannon Armitage will be going to university in Maine. So, a very international flavor in terms of schools that are going to be attended come September by these Nova Scotia girls. Nice to see as well. We certainly wish all of these athletes a lot of luck with their educational endeavors as they move forward through life. I know I'm stressed out that my daughter is actually going to junior high next year. Forget about going to another country to attend school. I got a 10-year-old that's going into grade 6, which is junior high, where I live in Truro, Nova Scotia. Whew, only a couple more months of elementary. My baby's going to junior high. Oh, dear. I'm sure any parents out there can relate to what I'm talking about. And if you're not a parent, well, perhaps one day you'll understand the stress I'm going through. If I had a stress emoji, I would use it right now. ball up high in the air, just crosses midfield right around that 50-yard line. Really has been a, it's hard to describe. It's I guess if I was using the vernacular of a boxing match, these two combatants have really been feeling each other out for almost the entire game. So, you know, I guess if we're using boxing and an analogy, we'd be in the seventh round and they're still feeling one another out. We're now well into this second half, and it's much the same. Although here's a chance, and just wide of the goal, as the words were coming out of my mouth, that it's been a hard time for either team to get anything offensive going. Nova Scotia had a chance from about 15 yards out and just poked it wide. Anxious moments there for Emma Connell in the Valley goal, and it was Caitlin Parker who will be going to Mount Allison, speaking of schools in September, who had the glorious chance there. And that's as close as we've come in this entire game. Ball forward now, and this looks like it's going to roll out of bounds. I want to say hello to Kelly Skinner. She tweeted out, three Nova Scotia players off to Acadia in the fall, too. Walsh, Buckler, and Monroe. And certainly, we want to mention those players as well. And the nice thing is that, you know, they're getting to get some extra time here on this turf here at Raymond Field, so it'll feel that much more like home when they actually play for their Atlantic University sport team in September. And again, that's a good reminder to let you know that Bell Alliant TV1 is the official broadcaster for Atlantic University sport. We'll be broadcasting games from all sports next season, including all championship games will be broadcast not only via webcast but also live on TV1, on Channel 1 and 401, exclusively to Bell Alliant Fiber Op TV customers. And I know last year we had an absolutely wonderful time covering all of the Atlantic University sports events, and we were, speaking of soccer, we were here at Acadia for the men's championship in the AUS in November, and I personally was in Moncton at the Université de Moncton for the women's championship final. The women's side, that was won by Ness Timmons and his Cape Breton University Capers. And the men's side, it was UNB. So UNB will be defending the soccer title on the men's side, CBU defending on the women's side. And before you know it, AUS Sports will be right back on your TV1 screens in just a few short months. So thank you, Kelly, for sending out that tweet. We appreciate it. You too can reach us on Twitter. Send out your tweet. Just use the hashtag TV1, just like Kelly did. If I see your tweet, I'll always attempt to either read it or retweet it. I think that sounds like a bumper sticker. If I see it, I'll read it or retweet it. Play now. Off to the side, reaching for it. There was Dolan. She's been dangerous for this Nova Scotia side here in this game. Dolan has it again. Just chips it to the back line now. Nova Scotia looks to move it forward. 1-0 is your score. Single goal scored by Team Nova Scotia. Or excuse me, no score, I should say. I apologize. There was a very close chance, though, moments ago by Nova Scotia. I guess I wanted it very badly to be a goal. As I look back on it, I thought it was in. Nova Scotia looking to push the issue again. tried to get it forward, but it's picked off by Valley United. They come back the other way with pace and unceremoniously knocked off the ball. There was Abby Cook, number 9 in red. She's back up and looks to be okay. Moving it forward there was Stevens for Valley. But United are turned right back around and have to regroup again. Nickerson goes to the back line. Valley trying to move it forward. Again, if it is a draw, that's the way it will end. They do not play an overtime period and there is not a shootout. So if it ends in a draw it shall be. And 23 and a half minutes left in this half. Ball will be inbounded by Valley United. Abby Cook inbounds, gets the ball right back. She gets challenged briefly there by Ferguson. Ball over in the middle now for Valley. Calmly up ahead for Katie Ross. Ross, nice ball forward. But again, you see both of these teams, once the offensive side starts to move it forward into around the 40 to 30 yard box area in the offensive zone, the defensive side just collapses in and shuts everything down. And that's the way it's been for Valley coming into Nova Scotia's end, and that's the way it's been for Nova Scotia going into Valley's end. Here's a long ball in now and coming out to challenge. And a good job there as McClatchy Gaudette came off the line to pick that ball out of the air. Valley strong on that ball. Trying to spin around and move it forward. It bounces off to the side. Madeline Lawrence in looking for it. Nova Scotia on it quickly. Mahoney gets it back. Trying to go up the side there, perhaps looking for Ferguson, but that didn't work. Ross gets taken off the ball there. Good work by Megan Fielding. Nice little straight pass up. Mahoney gets it back and then pushed all the way up. Henry tried to get it in and over top of Wombolt, but Wombolt wouldn't have any of that, and the ball goes out of bounds. So a nice 1v1 battle there between Nicole Wombolt from Valley and Rachel Henry from Nova Scotia. Inching our way towards the halfway point of this second half. Still no score. It's been a pretty tightly contested affair, and we've got a substitution coming now. Valley United subbing some players. Rachel O'Coin back into the game and taking a breather on the bench now. Abby Cook, so 7 in, 9 out for Valley United. And Rachel O'Coin was pretty active and a somewhat dangerous offensive player for Valley. We'll see what kind of spark she brings back to the pitch here. There's a shot in. It's off the bar and down. And that's as close as you're going to come. And I don't know, is the referee calling it a goal? They don't have goal line technology here like they do at FIFA. But that appeared to go off the crossbar and straight down. And I think that the Valley keeper, Emma Connell, thought that she had grabbed it in time. But the referee is signaling goal. So here we are in the 59th minute, and a goal finally scored. And I didn't see who struck that ball, but it just kind of came out of the pile, and it was a high, hard, rising shot straight off the bar and directly down onto the goal line. And I think Valley thought that the keeper had made the save in time, but a second or two later, the official signal goal, and that's where it is, 1-0. So that is quite a turn of events. I'll try to see if I can get the goal scorer, as again, there was kind of a crowd in front and that ball just kind of came out from a conglomeration of players, but it was a beautiful strike, and it was up over top of Emma Connell. And again, just beyond Connell's fingertips off the crossbar, straight down. And again, I think Valley thought that the save was made, but the side official obviously had a good view and said that it bounced in behind the line. So 1-0 Nova Scotia. Nova Scotia now working that ball forward, perhaps looking for more. Shannon Armitage trying to keep it in there was Dolan, and she couldn't quite get to it in time. Ball up into the middle part of the field now, working it back toward that 40-yard mark. Nova Scotia, Georgina Benang, or JJ as she's known as. Down to O'Coin, and that'll go out of bounds and be a goal kick for Valley United. So the keeper, Connell, rolls it up. And a mix of shadow, sunlight, and field lights coming into play here. A camera operator's nightmare. Hard to keep the iris of the camera at just the right balance to allow for the part of the field that's in shadow, part of it in sunlight, and part of it from the field lights. I got the easy part. I just have to stand here and talk. That ball goes out of play. Just coming up to about 16 and a half minutes left here in this second half. Nova Scotia, on the strength of that goal just moments ago, have the 1-0 lead. Play around midfield now. So we'll see if Nova Scotia is even more content now to play kind of a very guarded and close defensive game, kind of clamp things down just a little bit. Not that there was wide open offensive play before the goal, but certainly now you would think that potentially one goal could certainly stand up for the remaining 16 minutes. Given the way both of these teams have played defensively throughout. One more game left on the schedule for today, coming up at approximately 8:30 Atlantic time. It'll be some boys action coming your way. The Nova Scotia U18 side taking on the New Brunswick U17. And again, that'll be approximately 8:30 Atlantic time, our final game on the schedule today, and we'll be back at it tomorrow at noon Atlantic time. Full slate of action. We'll see teams from PEI and Newfoundland and Labrador hitting the pitch here at the U18 Atlantic Soccer Showcase tomorrow. Connell. Some good distance on that, but it goes right to Armitage, and she calmly plays it back to McClatchy Gaudette. Trying to get a chest on it there was Madeline Lawrence. Just went beyond her, but she continues the chase down the sideline right in the back pocket of Hannah Bruce. Bruce, little chip over, and then it's lifted high into the air. Knocked down there by O'Coin. O'Coin gets it back. She'll go all the way back now as Valley will look to set up a little better on the offensive side. Ball up ahead. And it goes out of play. Less than 15 minutes to go now. To be exact, or at least unofficially exact by my timer. Ball over into the middle and just below our broadcast area at midfield. Three Nova Scotia players getting ready to sub in here. Down the sideline with it is Armitage. She gets it up ahead for Henry. Henry goes into the middle and only a red jersey there, and Valley able to clear it away, but a nice cross there off the foot of Rachel Henry. Dolan puts her back to the defender, calmly gets it back to Armitage. Armitage forward. Comes down to Stevens for Valley, but Dolan reaches in and gets it forward, and Emma Connell will push it up and get it up the field for Valley United. 12:53 left in this second half. Slim one-goal lead for Nova Scotia. But at this point, Valley United, almost like they're trying to run in quicksand right now in terms of trying to break through that back line of the Nova Scotia defense and get anything in close to Alexa McClatchy-Gadette in the Nova Scotia goal. So here we go, some wholesale substitutions coming in now for Nova Scotia. Checking into the game, let me get these numbers here. We've got Kennedy Curry, number 8, Holly Buckler, number 11, and Julia Walsh, number 15, so 8, 11, and 15 all checking in for Nova Scotia. And it looks like, well, I got at least two of the players coming off for Nova Scotia, Rachel Henry and Shannon Armitage. 10 and 14 confirmed, two of the players coming off. So a few changes there, some subs in for Coach Kate McDonald. And we've got a Valley United player with a warm-up jacket on, stretching out on the sideline. So it looks like Valley United will be making a sub here shortly. And that's something, talking to all the coaches so far today, and I would expect it to continue certainly into tomorrow as well, but coaches wanting to get all their players onto the pitch and get them all a little action here to be part of this wonderful weekend event, this U18 Atlantic Soccer Showcase. Lots of universities here checking out these players from both the United States and Canada. Checking out players, A, that have already committed, and also looking at players that have yet to commit. So a big weekend for these players. And, you know, just because you've committed to a school and you're going to be going to school, that does not guarantee that you're going to make it onto the field and that you're going to get playing time. So, you know, a chance here for a lot of these players who obviously haven't committed to be seen by these recruiters and scouts, but also for the players who already have committed to, you know what, make an impression on the scouts or the coaches or recruiters and to say, hey, you did right by picking me. That ball going through the front part of the goal line, but no harm done there for Valley. Now we cross over into the final 10 minutes. So into the 71st minute now. And moving up with that ball is O'Coin. She goes into the middle, and Valley just seems stifled at this point. Cannot seem to get through the ball pressure from this Nova Scotia team. Nova Scotia sending in at least one attacker every time, trying to face up whoever has the ball and to force the issue. And there you go. You see Nova Scotia forcing a turnover once again. Just pressuring Valley, forcing them into turnovers. Coming up with it is Ferguson. Ferguson tried to get it forward, and a nice job there by O'Coin as she darted into the middle and cleared that ball out of harm's way. Nova Scotia tried to keep that ball in, but it goes out of bounds, so Valley quickly will throw in. See if Valley maybe can try to stretch out that defense, and there's a nice long ball for it. I think they need to do a little more of that. They've been trying to kind of pick their way through with little short passes, but as I look at the flags on the goalposts for football, it seems that the wind has died down a little bit, so I don't know, maybe in the last 8 minutes and 20 seconds here, try a few long balls forward. Try and stretch out that defense and see if you can get somebody in behind that wall of blue. Here comes Dolan. Dolan works it back into the middle. Ball bouncing forward there, knocked down. Nova Scotia keeping it forward. Dolan into the middle, headed away. Coming over now is Lawrence. Lawrence chips it up ahead. Straight up that line. And it's a blue jersey that gets there first, and it's number 8, Kennedy Curry. Curry will be playing for Ness Timmins and CBU this coming season. Here's O'Coin. Tried to get that ball through, but it's blocked down again by the Nova Scotia defensive line. Nova Scotia with the ball again. Ferguson calmly goes back to her teammate. Working up with it is Buckler. And now Ferguson once again. Smart little pass up ahead. But overcoming to force things was Katie Ross, and the ball goes out of bounds. So Nova Scotia will throw in Nicole Ferguson. And there's Katie Ross. Ross moving it back to O'Coin, and she goes over into the middle. United now will look to set something up again. They go far side of the field, over around that 45-yard mark on their side of the field. United trying to find a way to get through that Nova Scotia back line. Could this be the time that they can do it? They try to go up that far side, but again, Nova Scotia able to get there and intercept. Good battle for it over along that sideline. And the United player goes down heavily and the ball goes out of bounds. But pretty good effort there by Valley, trying to see if they can just work that ball in behind the Nova Scotia back line. Not a whole lot of time left in this half. Unofficially, I've got about 6 minutes and 15 seconds left. Nova Scotia moving that ball forward once again. Trying to organize their attack. Smart little pass up ahead there for Mahoney. Meanwhile, we've got the New Brunswick U-17 boys warming up, running through their paces in behind the Val United end. Just out of your camera view, but I can certainly have a good view of them as they do their warm-ups. And as mentioned, they'll be taking on the Nova Scotia U-18 boys coming up at about 8:30 Atlantic time. Not a whole lot of time left in this half. Just the one goal. It was scored in the 59th minute by Nova Scotia. And that's where we stand. It's a 1-0 lead, and it was a close play. It was a pretty powerful strike that went up over the fingertips of Emma O'Connell in the Valley United goal. Off the crossbar and straight down. And I think Valley thought that the ball was out, but the referee said it went behind the line. And that is the lone goal in this game. And that's where things stand. 1-0 for Team Nova Scotia. O'Coin with the little throw in, gets it right back. Tried to move it quickly ahead to Lawrence. Lawrence gets it off to O'Coin. O'Coin puts on the brakes, gets shoved down by Nicole Ferguson. Ferguson just kind of pushed her aside like she was wiping at a bug. That's as physical a play as we've seen in this game here. Back to Ferguson again now. Ferguson, little chip up ahead. I don't think that Mahoney saw it, had her back to it. Rushing up to try and get there with Serena Dolan. Dolan ahead now for Curry. Kennedy Curry trying to make a run here. Intercepted and turned back the other way by Valley. 3:45 left here, unofficially in this second half. United, well, all they need is one, but they need to get that ball on the Nova Scotia side of half. Playing it around midfield or in their own end, it's not going to do it for them. Katie Ross works it back to O'Coin. O'Coin again goes back, and Valley United has to regroup, and that's just fine with Nova Scotia. They'll keep 3-4 players back deep, try and prevent this type of thing, and there you see two United players there, but they just couldn't catch up to it, and there was a Nova Scotia defender back, and they just watch it roll harmlessly into the arms of McClatchy Gaudet. And that's the right idea. You got to try and stretch out that defense, see if you can get a through ball and get your players in behind that back line. But right now, with Nova Scotia keeping four, sometimes five, in that back portion, hard for Valley United to try and break through. United work that ball over. This is Katie Ross. Ross to O'Coin. Two good performers here for Valley United this afternoon, 7 and 19 in red. O'Coin and Ross. Ball chipped forward, calmly stopped there by Holly Buckler. Buckler gets it over into the middle. Spinning with it there was Parker. Caitlin Parker lost the handle on it, but again it goes back in control of Nova Scotia. They move it up ahead. Megan Fielding gets a nice ball ahead. Nicely done there. Nova Scotia in control now. Inside, 2 minutes to go. Long range shot there, just blocked down. That had some pace for sure. They try to work it over in the middle where Ferguson tried to direct it toward the Valley United goal. Good pressure by Nova Scotia. The other way now, it's Earl. Megan Earl. Trying to get past that blue Nova Scotia defensive line. Down deep in the corner, can they get that ball worked over toward the middle? High ball in, traffic in front. It bounces widely. Can they get their foot on it? No, it's cleared away. So there it was, the best look that Valley United has had in the last while. They had bodies in front. They worked it over toward the front. But Nova Scotia able to clear it away. Here's Ross now from long range. Gets it over into the middle. And McClatchy Gaudet gobbles it up. And she'll just settle things down. Unofficially about a minute left to go. We'll see how much time the referee adds on here. I can't imagine it would be more than a minute or two. But again, we'll have to wait and see. And that was a very, very anxious moment in front of that Nova Scotia goal. My timer says inside half a minute of regulation. Looks like there is going to be some added time. The call has come in to the timekeeper. We'll see if he turns around enough to show us here in the press box. United continues to push forward. And thank you very much, Mr. Timekeeper. 2 minutes. 2 minutes of added time. I just did my best impersonation of Wolf Blitzer from CNN. I said something twice. 2 minutes, 2 minutes. Ball forward there, knocked down by Nicole Ferguson. United. Wouldn't this be something now if they could equalize an extra time? Here's Lawrence, tried to get over to the middle. Blocked away and kicked up. Nova Scotia now just wants to get it in the air and out, and they do, much to the delight of the Nova Scotia faithful in attendance here. Andrea Mahoney enforcing the issue. Connell kicks it over. Unofficially, about 1 minute and 10 seconds left of the extra time. United trying to push it forward, trying to get through that crowd was Nicole Wombolt. And it rolls up, but McClatchy Gaudet will hang on to it. And she'll just be very deliberate in the way she picks it up. And Valley trying to block that kick. Comes down, move forward there. Buckler has it, goes over to the sideline with it. Ferguson stops it there. United trying to get it out, but coming up to deny was Buckler. And again, unofficially, my count says about 30 seconds of extra time left. Working with that ball now is Earl. Earl has it go out of bounds. And I'm sure Nova Scotia quite content just to keep the ball to the outside, keep putting out of bounds. It's thrown in there by Wombolt. And again, you see it go out. And all this does is kill time. Now again, the referee does have the discretion to add on to that 2 minutes that he put up there. Now, according to my stopwatch, that is exactly 2 minutes of extra time. So we are in extra time, as it were. And well, that's pretty much spot on to what the referee said. He called for 2 minutes. My official clock said 2:10. So a very tight defensive game comes to a close. One goal put up. It was by Nova Scotia in the 59th minute, and it stands up as the winner. So that game in the books. On behalf of the Bell Alliance TV One crew, I'm Scott Squires. You've been watching the Under 18 Atlantic Soccer Showcase presented by Soccer Nova Scotia, brought to you live and exclusively on Bell Alliance TV One. Once again, your final score, Nova Scotia Under 18 Girls 1, Valley United 0. We'll step aside, take a quick break. We'll be back at 8:30 Atlantic Time with our next matchup. It's Nova Scotia U18 Boys taking on New Brunswick U17 Boys. Until then, have a nice evening, and we'll see you at 8:30 Atlantic.